Witness. Do you remember what you said about the relations between you and the Führer?
May I read your words?
The chief influence on the Führer, if I may mention influence on the Führer at all, was up until the end of 1941 or the beginning of 1942, and that influence was I. Then my influence gradually decreased up until 1943, and from 1943 on, it decreased speedily. All in all, I do not believe anyone had anywhere near the influence on the Führer that I had, beyond or outside of myself. That is your view on that matter. Yeah. And I think you told the tribunal that right up to the end, your loyalty to the Führer was unshaken. Is that right?
Das ist richtig.
Do you still seek to justify and glorify Hitler after he had ordered the murder of these 50 young flying officers at Stalag-Luft 3?
Ich habe weder den Führer Adolf Hitler zu rechtfertigen noch zu glorifizieren, sondern ich habe nur zu betonen, dass ich ihm meine Treue gehalten habe, auch dann, denn ich halte es nicht für richtig, nur in guten Tagen, wenn man seinen Eid gegeben hat, die Treue zu halten, sondern es ist sehr viel schwerer, diese Treue dann auch in schweren Tagen zu halten. Ich habe aber, wenn Sie auf diese 50 Flieger anspielen, dem Führer niemals so klar und scharf gegenübergetreten, wie gerade in dieser Sache und ihm in dieser Sache meine Auffassung gesagt. Es hat dann monatelang überhaupt daraufhin kein Gespräch mehr zwischen mir und dem Führer stattgefunden.
The Führer at Tenerit must have had full knowledge of what was happening with regard to concentration camps, the treatment of the Jews and the treatment of the people who were working, mustn't he?
Ich sagte, deutete vorhin an, dass es meine Meinung ist, dass der Führer über Einzelheiten in den Konzentrationslagern, den hier geschilderten Grausamkeiten, nicht unterrichtet gewesen ist. So wie ich ihn kenne, glaube ich das jedenfalls nicht. Was aber zwischen ihm...
I'm not asking about details, I'm asking about the murder of 4 or 5 million people. Are you suggesting that nobody in power in Germany, except Himmler and perhaps Kaltenbrunner, knew about that?
Ich bin nach wie vor der Meinung, dass über solche Zahlen der Führer nicht Bescheid gewusst hat.
Now, you remember how Mr. Dallaire's described the relations between you and Hitler on page 53 of his book. From the very beginning of our conversation, I had resented his manner towards Goering, his most intimate friend and comrade from the years of struggle. His desire to dominate was explicable, but to require such obsequious humility as Goering now exhibited from his closest collaborator seemed to me excessively repellent and unprepossessing. Is that how you had to behave with Hitler?
So musste ich mich nicht Hitler gegenüber verhalten, so habe ich mich nicht gegenüber verhalten. Das sind feuilletonistische Äußerungen des Herrn Dallaire geschrieben nach dem Kriege. Wenn Deutschland den Krieg gewonnen hätte, würde diese Darstellung sicherlich in dem Buch eine ganz andere sein.
Well, Mr. Delerus was your witness, you know.
Ich habe nicht Herrn Delerus als Zeuge über seine Auffassungen in feuilletonistischen Ausdrücken gefragt, sondern ausschließlich über die Tatsachen, die er zwischen mir und der englischen Regierung als Kurier durchzuführen hatte.
My Lord, on the Tuesday of last week, the defendant called General Bodenschatz, who gave general evidence as to his character and reputation. He therefore, in my respectful submission, makes me entitled to put one document to him, which is an account by the defendant Raeder of his general character and reputation. In accordance with the English practice, I make my submission and ask the court's permission to put it.
Tribunal rules that at the present stage this document cannot be used in cross-examination.
Lord, I understand from that that your lordship leaves open the question for further argument as to whether it can be used when the defendant Raeder is in the witness box.
Yes.
Much obliged. Now, the witness, you said before the tribunal adjourned that Hitler, in your opinion, did not know about, broadly, was ignorant about the question of concentration camps and the Jews. I'd like you to look at document D-736. That is an account of a discussion between the Führer and the Hungarian regent Horthy on the 17th of April 1943. And if you would look at page 4, do you see the passage? Just after Nürnberg and Fürth.
Einen Augenblick, ich wollte nur ganz kurz überfliegen, um zu der Identität Stellung nehmen zu können. Eventuell.
Sidney. Lord, this document.
Seite 4.
GB2, page 4. GB 283. Do you see, after the mention of Nuremberg and Fürth, Hitler goes on, the Jews did not even possess organizational value. In spite of the fears which he, the Führer, had heard repeatedly in Germany also, everything continued to go its normal way without the Jews too. Where the Jews were left to themselves, as for instance in Poland, the most terrible misery and decay prevailed. They are just pure parasites. In Poland, this state of affairs had been fundamentally cleared up. If the Jews there did not want to work, they were shot. If they could not work, they had to succumb. They had to be treated like tuberculosis bacilli, with which a healthy body may become infected. This was not cruel, if one remembered that even innocent creatures of nature, such as hares and deer, have to be killed, so that no harm is caused by them. Why should the beasts who wanted to bring us Bolshevism be spared more? Nations which did not rid themselves of Jews perished. One of the most famous examples of this was the downfall of a people who were once so proud, the Persians, who now lead us a pitiful existence as Armenians. And would you look at document 170, which is an exhibit and which is a conference which you had on the 6th of August, 1942. Yes.
Before you part from that document, is there not a passage higher up which is important?
Oh, yes, I'm so sorry, my lord.
Counter-question. It's about 10 lines down, I think, in the middle of the line. To Horthy's counter-question.
Yes. To Horthy's counter-question as to what he should do with the Jews now that he had deprived them of almost all possibility of livelihood, he could not kill them off. The Reich Foreign Minister declared that the Jews must either be exterminated or taken to concentration camps. There was no other possibility. I'm very grateful. Now, if you...
Kennt dieses Dokument nicht.
Now, this is a conference which you had with a number of people, and on page 143, if you turn to it, you get on to the question of butter. If you would look where it says Reich Marshal Göring, how much butter do you deliver? 30,000 tons. Do you see that?
Yeah.
And then Loser, who is in the conference, says yes. And you say, do you also deliver to Wehrmacht units? And then Loser says, I can answer that too. There are only a few Jews left alive. Tens of thousands have been disposed of. But I can tell you that the civilian population gets on your orders, they get 15% less than the Germans. I call your attention to that statement. There are only a few Jews left alive. Tens of thousands have been disposed of. Do you still say, in face of these two documents, that neither Hitler or you knew that the Jews were being exterminated?
Ich bitte, dass meine Bemerkung richtig verlesen wird. Sie ist völlig falsch wiedergegeben. Ich darf den Originaltext verlesen. Lose. Also nicht meine Bemerkung, ich meine Loses Bemerkung. Darauf kann ich auch antworten. Die Juden leben nur noch zum kleinen Teil. Zigtausend sind weg. Hier steht nicht, dass sie vernichtet worden sind. Aus dieser Bemerkung ist nicht zu schließen, dass die dort getötet worden sind, sondern dass aus dieser Bemerkung nur geschlossen werden kann, dass die Juden dort weg sind, also evakuiert, konnte genauso möglich sein. Steht
the
nicht davon.
The preceding remark I suggest you make it quite clear. It is there are only a few Jews left alive.
Nein, leben noch dort. So ist das aufzufassen.
Well, now, you heard what I read to you about Hitler, what he said to Horthy, and what the defendant Ribbentrop said, that the Jews must either be exterminated or taken to concentration camps, and what Hitler said, that the Jews must either work or be shot. That was in April 43. Do you still say that neither Hitler or you knew of this policy to exterminate the Jews?
Ich habe für die Richtigkeit dieser Niederschrift keinen Beweis. Sollte Hitler dies...
Will you answer my question? Do you still say that neither Hitler or you knew of the policy to exterminate the Jews?
Soweit es Hitler betrifft, habe ich gesagt, dass ich das nicht glaube. Soweit es mich betrifft, habe ich gesagt, dass ich auch nur annähernd von diesem Ausmaß das nicht gewusst habe.
You didn't know to what degree, but you knew that there was a policy that aimed at the extermination of the Jews.
Nein, auf die Auswanderung der Juden und nicht auf ihre Ausrottung. Ich wusste nur, dass in Einzelfällen in dieser Richtung Vergehen vorgekommen waren.
Thank you.